those videos, 3 minutes of photo wisdom. I meant to make this outside, but my signal strength on my phone was not that good. Well, it is the case in the hierarchy, and I created this chart, that in the hierarchy of importance, it is stated that you date the cameras, but you marry the glass. Everybody ultimately is invested in an ecosystem. They have a certain set of glass. In the hierarchy of what's important, it is mind. Secondly is lighting. Third is lens. Fourth is camera. Five, post-production. Six, printing, so on and so forth. So the camera falls really low on the totem pole. Obviously, first, eidos, or the eidetic, the creation, like, oh my god, that'd be a great idea for a shot. Like you see, like today, when I was walking in the park, you see these trees that are planted in perfectly straight lines. You can actually use that compositionally for portraiture. It would make a really wonderful shot. Instantly, things pop in your head. Secondly is lighting. Actually, number three after that would not be lens, but lighting control. People think, well, I got the lighting, you know, now it's time. No, lighting control. It's like having, I don't know, 1,000 cattle, but no friends to surround. Where are my cattle? Well, they're out there somewhere. It's like, well, where? Well, they're somewhere. You gotta let them go. Well, you got the cows, but you have no control over it. So lighting control, then the lens, then the camera. So the camera sits really low on the totem pole. 3 minutes of wisdom on this is that, I don't know about you, you know, if you might be super rich and you just like have a dispensing machine for the next camera after the one before it broke down. Most of you are not like that, and to me, I find it slightly important as far as camera performance. A lot of working professionals don't show up on a shoot with a second body or backup body. Everything in the world is redundancy, right? Redundancy. There are very few things in life you have no redundancy on except for your body, right? Which is why you should be in good health, unlike myself, right? The fact that the camera sits low on the totem pole has nothing to do with the also additional fact that, you know, when your camera, you know, goes teats up and takes a pee on your shoes, you know, kind of like a dog is scared and it pees on your shoes, that's not a good thing, right? A really funny comment was left a day before yesterday or something, and this is so funny I nearly die laughing. It says, the camera gets so hot that you have to start watching out for hobbits because they want to throw a ring into the camera. Camera gets so hot that you have to look out for hobbits because they want to throw a ring into your camera. Now that's pretty funny. That's pretty funny. Not too many well-made non-disposable products anymore. Actually, currently the best make, as far as durability and longevity and camera bodies, is Fujifilm. Obviously, electronics and autofocus and buffer and megapixel increases, obviously always necessitatively obsoletes cameras, but currently they're making the best. Second would be Nikon. Third would be Canon. But pick whatever you like, obviously. In the hierarchy of things, like I said, cameras are not that important, but you're attached to that camera because you have that X ecosystem of glass. That's understandable, so just think about things wisely before making a decision, and don't base it off decisions of people that have any invested interest in you choosing one thing over another. Make the logical, intelligent choice based upon facts and what you need and the right tool for the right job.